This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
Hello and welcome to Walk the Talk. I am Shekhar Gupta in Delhi's Lalit Kala Academy. And my guest today is not only one of India's most creative and most durable artists, he's also a most wonderfully warm human being, the finest man to have as a friend in any city, particularly in this one. Mr. Satish Gujral, welcome to Walk the Talk.
Thank you.
And helping us in this is your very talented son, Mohit. To interpret my words to you.
Thank you very much.
And I know very little about art. As you know, I'm a Philistine. You've known me for many years now. From where do you find this creative energy? You know, every few years you produce so much work and always something new. What is the secret?
It is like you do not ask where I get the energy to breathe. Similarly, my energy to create is automatic. Without it, I cannot live.
Sir, I'm 50 साल की उम्र में बुढ़े हो गए, but you carry on in your 80s.
कहने मैं हम तो 50 साल में बुढ़े हो गए हैं. आप अभी भी energy.
Because I think when you are consistently in creative activities, it fills you with energy, life, and this zest to live on and on. I cannot think I am going to end only when I think this creativity may end. I think that will be the end of myself. The reason I create every time new, because I am forced to live in a silent world. When there is silence all around you, the consequence of it is you doubt your own being. You want to find a proof whether you exist, because nothing brings you a proof that you are. Then I create, and when I create something out of nothing, it gives me a proof that I am a being, I am there. But if I create same thing again and again, it will be like inhaling what I have just exhaled. So every time I want a new breath, a new style, a new thing to work with.
You know, you talked about living a life of silence. Now, living a life of silence is a big challenge. But sometimes, is it also a creative asset?
Silence works both ways. One that I have already explained to you, that it makes you doubt your own existence.
Right.
On the other hand, it makes you to listen to yourself.
Right.
In war times, our sages traveled far from civilization to be alone, to be in silence, so that to listen to themselves. Famous poet Iqbal had once said, "Is khamshi mein jaein, is khamshi mein jaein, kitne buland nale, taaron ke kafle ko meri sada dara ho." That in this silence, how high could rise my voice, so high that it could provide guidance to the stars. That is the benefit. I had not known it before, because when silence came and I started to live with it, when I was only 8 years old, I soon forgot how otherwise it is. So I did not know it was a gift also. But about 10 years ago, I had an implant.
Right, a cochlear implant, yes.
this implant brought back the sound. Once the sound came back, at first I was excited. But soon I started to feel miserable. I had lived in a world of my own, like a blind man has a certain image of life around you. Every face he has an idea, according to. He might think a very ugly woman to be a very beautiful one. And then if you bring him back the sight, it will be approached him from a world he had lived. So is with sound. Sound also make effect on the image around you. As you start living that world. When my hearing came back, I found the image were not what I thought they were. That was very disturbing. I could not reinvent things. I longed for the same challenge. So I got the implant removed.
And because for nearly 70 years, you were used to silence.
After 65
years. 65 years, you were used to silence.
It was a long time. So much that when I approached the specialist in Australia that I want to have this implant, he was a bit uncomfortable. He thought at this age and after so long, he is not very sure I have the stamina to take it. He warned me to be ready for a world you do not know. But I was excited. I wanted to have it. But then I do not regret why I had it. It gave me now a new vision for what I have lost. Now I think it is a gift. Before I thought it was a handicap.
Satishi, your works, if I see so many of them, and I said I know very little about art, so much empty space. Are you talking about silence? All this empty space. Is this
कुछ काम विच बड़ी खाली जगह है इधर silence नाल कोई association?
Oh, when this new journey began, then 4 years ago, I started to develop this style with the large space. I had seen tonkas of the Tibet. With very large space empty, then an image in the center, like the man alone in the universe, trying to find his place. So a large space gives meaning to that small thing. So they are discovery, which are also a part of the same process. I began to discover in these 10 years.
In the 10 years after you got the implant removed?
Oh, I think first I thought having it was good.
Right.
Then I thought removing it was better.
So why don't you tell us some, explain some of these paintings to us and sculptures.
Kuch kaam samjhao ke uske piche kya meaning hai.
That will be a difficult question. We often ask the artist to tell the meaning. Like a musician hears the meaning in melody, not in words. Similarly, an artist thinks in form, not in idea. Artists are not men of ideas. They are men of feeling. Feeling cannot be spoken. It can only be created into form itself. When I paint it, like a mother gives birth to a child, I myself do not know what is coming. Then I see it before me, like you saw it. Then I try to find what is it, what the meaning is. But if the meaning were in idea, that will be wrong. Ideas convert, but art liberate. I do not give title. I do not give guidance so that you find your own truth. It will liberate you. A man come here, like saying, two men look out from the same bar. One sees the mud and one the star.
So each one has to make his own mind.
Har aadmi ko apni
interpretation.
Aapne itna versatile kaam kiya, painting kiya, sculpture kiya, architecture kiya, sab kuch kiya. Sabse zyada maza kis mein aaya?
Kya aapne itne zyada medium try kiye hain, usme painting, sculpture, architecture, aapko sabse zyada maza kis mein aaya?
I am often asked this question, but there is no answer. Liking depends on mood. In a given mood, I wanted to build. In another mood, I wanted to paint. Now, for example, when I was spellbound by architecture, when I wanted just to build, I did not paint. But now, my whole being was dissolved in building. I wanted to do it. But once the mood was gone and I came back to paint, recently I wanted to build a studio for myself. And I asked my son Mohit to design it because I am not in the mood for architecture.
But it's easy for you. You have the finest architect sitting in your home.
After all, I produced him.
Yes, absolutely.